David Davey Michael Gordon Graham. Lived from 26 November 1940 to the 15th of December 2008, was a British guitarist and one of the most influential figures in the 1960s British folk revival. He inspired many famous practitioners of the fingerstyle acoustic guitar such as Bert Jansch, John Renbourn, Martyn Carthy, Ralph McTell, Wizz Jones, John Martyn, Nick Drake, Ritchie Blackmore, and Paul Simon, as well as folk rock bands such as Fairport Convention and Pentangle. Jimmy Page based his solo White Summer on Graham's She Moved Through the Fair. Graham is probably best known for his acoustic instrumental, Anji, and for popularizing D-A-D-G-A-D tuning. One of Graham's lasting legacies is the D-A-D-G-A-D open sus4 guitar tuning, which he popularized in the early 1960s. While traveling in Morocco, he developed the tuning so he could better play along with and translate the traditional oud music he heard to guitar. Graham then went on to experiment playing traditional folk pieces in D-A-D-G-A-D tuning, often incorporating Indian and Middle Eastern scales and melodies. A good example is his arrangement of the traditional air She Moved Through the Fair, which he recorded live at the Troubadour in Earl's Court in 1964. The tuning provides freedom to improvise in the treble, while maintaining a solid underlying harmony and rhythm in the bass, though it restricts the number of readily playable keys. While guitarists used non-standard or non-classical tunings before this, for example, open E and open G in common used by blues and slide guitar players, D-A-D-G-A-D introduced a new standard tuning. Many guitarists now use the tuning, especially in folk and world music. During the 1960s, Graham released a string of albums of music from all around the world in many genres. 1964's folk, blues and beyond, and the following year's collaboration with the folk singer Shirley Collins, Folk Roots, New Roots, are frequently cited among his most influential album releases. The second album, called Folk Blues and Beyond, mixes blues with an elaborate guitar backing to the traditional song Seven Gypsies, played in a style that was to be known as folk baroque, as well as excursions into jazz and Moroccan themes. The third album, Folk Roots, New Roots, was recorded with the folk singer Shirley Collins, and mixed folk songs such as Nottingham Town with jazz-influenced tracks, from Thelonious Monk's Blue Monk to Bobby Timmons's Grooveyard. But admiration for the jazz world lifestyle had a devastating effect on Graham, who began to inject heroin and registered himself as a drug addict. According to Carthy, he was a lovely man, but he was enthralled to jazz players like Charlie Parker, and the whole drug culture. And though there was very little heroin on the British folk scene, he deliberately became a junkie. I remember Alexis Corner's fury when he found out. His continuous touring of the world as a beat mystic traveler, picking up and then recording different styles of music for the guitar, has resulted in many musicians crediting him with founding world music. However, though Graham recorded in a variety of genres and loved to play the oud, he was no purist, absorbing all his influences into his own ever-expanding conception of the possibilities of guitar music.
In 1959, this generation of young European hard travelers found their own homegrown guru.
The first time I ever saw Davey was on that program. I sat there watching this man play and I just couldn't believe what I was hearing and seeing. It was the first time I'd heard anybody of, you know, what you can loosely describe as our lot, playing like that. He is the man who is responsible for the great leap forward, if you like, in guitar playing.
Dave was the leader. He was the first one. He's the beginning of the style. He would flit from here to there to everywhere. He'd stop halfway on along something and say, "Have you heard this?" and start something completely different. You know, so that you could never quite follow him.
In the days when everybody else was really scruffy with long beards and long hair and wearing scabby t-shirts and jeans, Davey was there and he was immaculate. 1950s jazzer.
actually take any sound he heard, anything, it didn't matter what it was, be it a Charlie Mingus big band, and condense it to one track on a guitar. And no one else I've ever known has that ability to do that.
Davey Graham, a Londoner of mixed Scottish and Guyanese descent, was an elusive and mercurial hero. In 1962, he delivered his followers their first instrumental standard.
Davey doesn't like me doing it because I play it too fast and I play all the wrong notes. But I do still like actually playing it. But it's called Anji.
Simon himself said at that time when he was in London, we were all learning off everybody else. If somebody came up with a new trick, everybody was latching onto it, because we all of us wanted to improve. You know, we all latched onto everything that Davey did.
Davey Graham has a theory that there is a connection between Oriental music and the folk music of Ireland. And to prove this, he's going to play for us his own variation of the Irish melody, She Moves Through the Fair.
Davey's version of She Moves Through the Fair. I was absolutely stunned by this. It was improvisational, but he was also using the guitar in a way I'd never heard it used before. It just blew me away. I couldn't figure out how he'd done it. The guy who played it to me, a guy called Gordon Geeky, Gordon explained to me that he had the guitar tuned differently. And that was something that had never occurred to me.
What Davey was getting away from was the idea that you had to be orchestral. He was playing melodically rather than harmonically, and the chords are suggested rather than imposed.
To tune the guitar something like the sitar, the sarod, and I took up the oud, the Arab lute. I played the sarod for about 10 years, not to anybody's, nobody noticed, I don't think, and but I was quite serious about the Arab lute. I never mastered the question and answer antiphonal responses between treble and bass that you get with that sort of music. It's more particularly the natural style on the instrument.
He's a very hard man to follow. I don't mean musically, but I mean I'd like to keep up with him. Because he'll jump from one subject to another mid-sentence, you know. It's all logical in his mind.
I spent nearly 20 years studying Afghan and Iraqi Takassim modes, and they strike the lover of English folk music very oddly, if at all.
Joseph Husband, come tell me why.
But Davey Graham was never one to shirk a challenge, and for his next musical adventure, he teamed up with folk's most celebrated English rose.
As soon as I saw Blonde, oh, she, I must confess to you, she nearly knocked me sideways.
He was lovely, but he was cold. And although the music itself was so utterly passionate, you know, he was a sort of dispassionate person. Very disciplined, except he took drugs, you know, which I didn't.
But to see a Shirley sing, I rode to church last Sunday, my true love passed me by. I knew his love was changing from the rolling of his eye, you know. Just looked so absolutely wonderful, you know. And so struck by her as a all I loved about England, about green sleeves, about Vaughan Williams' Fantasia on a theme by Thomas Tallis, all that.
It was wonderful to work with him because he really did sort of enhance this music and give it such sort of strength, I think, as well, and present it to people in a way that we hadn't thought to hear, you know, we hadn't thought of listening to it like that before.
In Norton Town, not a soul would look up.
By fusing the two strands of the folk movement, Folk Roots, New Roots became a defining moment for British folk music.
I think it was influential in the sense of opening people's ears to the wider possibilities of what was being done. I think without that album, we wouldn't have had Pentangle, we wouldn't have had Fairport's Legion Leaf.
While Davey Graham and Shirley Collins' fusions were well received critically, they barely registered commercially.